All right, bro. So look, it's crazy because, bro, this dude, Charleston White, keeps finding a way into my face, bro. It's crazy. Pause. But just today, I was chilling, whatever, doing my thing. And then all of a sudden, my friend sends me a video with Aiden Ross's man, Prime, the dude with the dreads or whatever, that's been making his rounds, rocking with Aiden, kind of serving as like Aiden's porch monkey, you know, like for real. Showing out, doing the most, all this type of stuff, bro. I'm not going to lie. Based on what I've seen and how he's been conducting himself, he's moving like a buster, bro. I can't lie. And what I mean is, right? Do you remember when him and Charleston White got into it? And this video isn't about Charleston White, but it's really about Prime. But do you remember when Prime and Charleston White got into it? And Charleston White pressed dude to the max, like he pressed him the hardest that anybody could ever be pressed in their life. You dig what I'm saying? Let me see, man. He pressed this dude to the max. When they got up, got into each other's face, right? Got into it.
Hey, nigga, you ain't gonna do that, nigga. What you gonna do here, nigga?
You better get that way.
What you gonna do?
You gonna get your knife?
I don't get no knife. I know what you do. And then I'm gonna throw the punch, nigga. Then I'm gonna, what you gonna do, bitch ass?
He got mace, you wanna get close.
And I'm gonna spray it too, nigga. Keep talking, nigga. I'm gonna spray it like you gonna do something, nigga. You ain't gonna do a motherfucking thing.
I know how to handle the situation.
What the fuck, bro? Come on, homie, you just came and jumped into something. You ain't got nothing to do with that.
It's just not that shit.
And then he started putting his jacket on.
None of that shit is serious.
Bro, when you got a dude standing over you, tripping on you, potentially, he ain't used it yet, right? But he got... And you're in a situation where somebody is... Well, they're talking still, so obviously, you know, words are words, violence is violence. Ain't nothing happened yet, but... Prime is in a situation where he got his back turned to the threat. He not trying to address this man head up anymore. Now that he knows dude is serious, you know what I mean? He explaining himself. And all throughout this encounter, I was disappointed in how Prime conducted himself. Because I was like, look, this man be playing extra gangstered out.
Well, he want to fight. No, nothing happened.
I understand.
You know what I mean? He playing extra gangstered out. And then he's like, right, man, he got mace. I'm not trying to do this. I'm not trying to do that. Like, bro, if you're a thug, if you're serious, if you're really about that life, and I see a lot of dudes, young dudes that are like that, where, you know, they'll sit there and talk crazy and wild out on somebody that maybe older than them or smaller than them, or they think, oh, he's a sucker, bro. I'm going to just keep playing with him. I'm going to keep talking to him. Then when somebody finally checks their temperature and say, all right, bro, well, if it's like that, then let's get down. And then he like, nah, bro, it's not even that serious. That's what happens. A lot of people get punked down when they feel as though, oh yeah, nah, bro is a threat, right? So I figured, you know what, Prime, he don't got that dog in him like that. He's not cut like that, right, bro? Today my cousin sent me this, and I'm like, bro, this dude Jack Doherty, I don't know if you ever seen his stuff, right? Let's look his situation up. Basically, he antagonizes people on YouTube. If I'm not mistaken, I'm pretty sure a lot of this stuff is staged. Yeah, like, I'm pretty sure a lot of this stuff is staged and stuff like that, right? You dig what I'm saying? But Prime, I guess he slapped or he sucker punched Jack Doherty, right? Slapped the goofy out this dude, bro. And that's part of his bit, is to have people physically assault him, which is crazy. You know what I mean? Doing it for clout, but not doing it to defend yourself. That looks dumb, bro. I'm not gonna lie. And I hate the fact that this dude, bro, you got all these white boys in there filming dude. You know what I mean? Got him looking crazy. Got him looking at, like, he's really just tap dancing for, you know, Aiden Ross. Now Jack Doherty, all these dudes. It's a bad look because he was so extra hostile towards Charleston White for being cool or getting cool with Aiden Ross on some genuine type shit, trying to get some money with dude or whatever. But he got all this smoke on some, like, you know, some clout chasing type shit, on some fraudulent shit. And I wish that people would stop playing gangster on the internet. I wish that people would stop internet banging, putting shit on the dead homies. Like, that whole Charleston White situation, dude is talking about, yeah, bro, dead homies. And I personally know niggas that are like that, where They always blowing up the dead homies. You're talking about, oh yeah, I'm gonna do this, I'm gonna do that on this, on that, putting it on something. You know, you're not even supposed to be doing that unless you really are serious about doing something or have already done something. And you did, and then you put it on whatever it is that you did. You know what I mean? I'm not gonna lie, this struck me, it struck a nerve with me, because not even that long ago, I went through a situation where we had to check the temperature of niggas that knew them growing up. Next thing you know, I guess they turned gangster, but they started getting high, they broke, they're angry, they're irritated, they're hungry. And they taking that out on niggas that they've been known. They taking that out on niggas that we was just trying to do our thing and chill, but you know, people want to do the most. And honestly, niggas like this are the reason why people look at, like, say I go up to somebody and tell them, like, oh yeah, you know, I'll be on YouTube, I'm doing my thing, right? Or I stream or whatever. You know, they're gonna immediately be like, oh, so you like Prime, are you like, you know? And it's like, that's a bad look. Not just for me, but for him and for everybody else, for all black content creators. When there's shit like that jumping off, now I understand why Soluminati walked away. You dig what I'm saying? Now I understand why some of the OGs got such a disdain for the young bulls who, yeah, you're trying to get a dollar out here, but at the same time, at what cost, bro? Look at what you're doing. Look at how kookly you look. You dig what I'm saying? This is gonna be a short video today because I got a lot of stuff to do, but I seen this and I was like, you know what, I kind of want to give my opinion on it, because especially in my generation, bro, I'm 25, so you know, dudes that are around my age, maybe a little younger, are always, now they're in the position of where there's like, the dynamic is like big white streamer and then like porch monkey black, token black dudes that like bring all the comedy and the comedic relief, and they just kind of cause a headache for the white dude. That's like the dynamic of the entertainment of streaming right now, where there's always like some dude. That's the reason why I rock with AMP so tough, and that's the right reason why I rock with Kai Cenat so tough, because they don't need any of that booth going on. They literally are just a bunch of ethnic folks interacting with each other and creating those moments, and they have complete ownership of their vibe. Nobody is facilitating it. They're not tap dancing for anybody. It's 100% respectable. So I hope, you know, I want to say hashtag free Prime, man. Hopefully he gets himself up out of there, because all this tap dancing and cooning that man is on, that that man is doing for no reason, making himself look crazy, antagonizing it, really niggas that he should consider his OG, just antagonizing them. And then now this is the next outing that we get from bro. You know what I mean? Like, come on, dog. Honestly, that's not the move. It's really not. And it's disappointing and it's sad to see, because I'm really technically in the same sphere, which, you know, when it comes to just like making YouTube videos and doing content on the internet. So that type of shit really does make it to where it's a little harder for someone like me to organically come up in this shit. You dig what I'm saying? That's how I feel about it. But anyways, leave a like, subscribe, man. Follow my sponsors, Laxtra Worldwide, Laxtra_Worldwide on Instagram. I'll leave the link in the bio. I'll leave a link in the description. Go ahead and follow them and shop with them when they drop. Right now, I got a bit of a friends and family drop going on with their latest effort, the athletic trunks. They're pretty fire, two colorways, all the shit. So if you want to see everything, follow my Instagram, follow their Instagram, and just shit, bro, tap in with me.